Hi, I'm Nathan Greene. I'm an artist, an illustrator, and I started my career in Chicago back in the early 1980s. I went to the American Academy of Art and then started illustrating for many publishers in that area back in about 1983, 84. A couple of years into my career as an illustrator, I think it might have been 1985 or 86, right around there, I got a call from Jeff Dever in Washington, D.C., asking if I would be interested in doing a series of illustrations for the curriculum for Seventh-day Adventist education for Seventh-day Adventist schools around the country. It was called the Reader's Life Series. And I'd already been doing some illustrations for public school textbooks in Chicago for Scott Swarzman and Publishing and McDougall and Littell. And I like doing this type of work. And so I said yes. They sent me some of the stories to be illustrated. And one of them that particularly caught my attention and really pleased me was the story of the life of Hank Aaron. He was very significant to me. I was born in 1961. And so I was probably, I think I was about 13 years old when he broke Babe Ruth's record for the most home runs ever hit by one player. I think it was around 714, if I remember right. I loved baseball growing up. I grew up in Detroit. I went to Southfield Junior Academy, Seventh-day Adventist grades, I believe, 1 through 12 school in Detroit area. And baseball was kind of our number one thing. In fact, when the World Series came to Detroit, I was really impressed that the school teachers at Southfield actually allowed us to take time off from our studies and watch on a large TV in the gymnasium, one or two of the World Series games that were played in the daytime. So when I got the opportunity to illustrate the story of Hank Aaron, I was thrilled. At that time in 1985, I didn't do oil painting. First 5 years or so as an illustrator, I did mostly opaque watercolors, a medium called gouache, which is like watercolors, only they have opaque pigments that make them look more solid and less transparent. So the illustrations I did for Hank Aaron were done in gouache or opaque watercolors. I was sent by the publisher a few photographs of Henry Aaron when he was in his career, one from early on in his career. I think he had a career spanning several decades, actually. I had to pose a little boy batting a ball for one of the illustrations where he apparently, Hank Aaron, when he was a young boy, used to take a wad of rags with string tied around them, and he would take a broom handle and hit that ball up on the roof or against the wall of their garage. And that's how he got his practice as a young man. When he was about 13 years old, he was taken to a game where he was able to see Jackie Robinson play. And most of you would know, of course, that Jackie Robinson was the first African-American player to play in the major leagues. And as the story is told, when Hank Aaron came home, he told his father, "I want to do that someday. I want to play Major League Baseball." And he was only 13, but I thought it was pretty neat that a young man at that age would start his set a goal for himself to do something that he really longed to do. And apparently when he was in his teens, he got noticed and was invited to play in a minor league baseball team. And it wasn't long before he was noticed by the major leagues because he had profound talent. The Hank Aaron story especially really was meaningful to me for a number of reasons. When he set the new record for the most home runs in the major leagues, his manager made a comment, and I'm paraphrasing, but it was he well deserved it because he is such a gentleman. This is my understanding of Hank Aaron, that he was a man of character. He was a gentleman. He was humble and modest. He was not arrogant, and he was just a good man. And I think to set people like this that have demonstrated integrity and honesty and decency, to set them as examples for not only ourselves, but for our young people, I think is really important. it's the reason why in most more recent years, some of my artwork on American history has mainly featured people of integrity and decency.